So I've closed the coat at the top now, which really is our signature chic look. A little button. A little button on the top here with a little crochet loop, and it gives it this beautiful diagonal line. I usually leave the middle button open so that this can fall exactly as it wants to, rather than being restricted by something halfway down. But on a lot of people it does just sit in the perfect place. I'm wearing a size 1, which is a relaxed fit on me now. Probably could also wear the size down, but this is the more comfortable size for me. It's a medium, size 1. This is just like the most comfortable alternative to a blazer you could possibly want. Gentle shape. We've added plenty of material around the hip. Pockets. Beautiful square horn button. These are hand carved for us. It's ethical horn. And we got them specially made. And this is Dijon. Such a chic colour, very unusual. Would it look beautiful with amber jewellery and wearing a sort of browns and khakis and things? I do love the colour. It's one of those colours, if it suits you, it's just spectacular. Obviously the yellow tone is not ideal for everyone. I can only wear it when I've really got quite a strong tan, but I wouldn't be without it in the collection. So this is the short signature coat with pockets with the tulip dress, and we have lots and lots of colour combinations. The short signature coat comes in pretty much every colour in my collection, because it's just the classic that sells and sells. Most of my customers do have it in a few colours. It's lovely to have it sort of in some classic navy and coconut, but then to sort of have the more interesting colours to add as a sort of an accessory colour to your wardrobe. Over to the colour chart. Oh, obviously those are autumn, winter, fall, winter colours. My spring to fall colour chart is growing. I tend not to discontinue many shades, but this is the Dijon that I have on. And the signature coat, as I say, comes in really most of these colours. You definitely, I would say, most of the time want to go for a size down to what you think you might be, because you want it to be fitted at the shoulder. I think this is coming up a little bit big on me at the moment, because I've managed to get a little bit fitter over the lockdown. And although it doesn't stretch, it will give a little bit as you wear it. It kind of becomes your size, so it's always better to make sure that the shoulder is a neat fit. The springiness of this knit means that there's lots of material here, so don't be afraid to try a size down rather than a size up. It'll look a lot smarter, and that gives you more versatility if you can wear it sort of dressed up as well as sort of slouchy and drapey.